So what else is out that
it's
we might
complicated.
Be interested in?
The latest from Nancy Myers, who directed Something's Gotta Give and Holiday and things like that. Anyway, so it's already up for... I think she's nominated for a Golden Globe, and I think Muriel Strepsil is also nominated for a Golden Globe.
Hi, I'm Meryl Streep.
Hello, I'm... Yeah, have we got that? We should have that as a card. Shoot. Hello, I'm
a
Meryl
cart.
Streep.
What's a card?
Well, that's what they used to... Well, when the last time I was DJing, it was a cart was a thing that you had a bit of tape on that you put it in and it went,
oh,
hi, I'm Meryl Streep. A cartridge, yeah. So the story is Meryl Streep is a divorcee who was married to Alec Baldwin. He has now divorced her and has married a younger woman. There's a little bit of business about the fact that the younger woman then left Alec Baldwin, went off, got pregnant by somebody else, came back to have the kid with Alec Baldwin. Now, Alec Baldwin and Muriel Strepsil find themselves falling into... love or bed again together and having an affair. Here's a clip.
Why haven't you returned any of my calls or emails?
Jake, come on. This is just too weird. We have to just never do what we did ever again. You're an adulterer and I am an awful person, basically. I haven't slept in days. What we did was so wrong. On so many levels.
And it was so right on a couple of levels, too. Admit it.
No, it wasn't. On no levels was it right.
You can't say we didn't enjoy each other's company. Sitting at the bar, dancing, after dancing. Come on. You and I haven't had fun like that in 100 years.
Yes, because we're not supposed to have fun like that. We are divorced.
See... In Something's Gotta Give, there was that very good gag when, because it's Diane Keaton and Jack Nicholson, and Jack Nicholson says, what are we going to do about birth control? And Diane Keaton says, the menopause. So in terms of the things that are good about It's Complicated, is that, you know, she seems to have sort of cornered the market in the idea of, you know, older people, and I say this incidentally as a man who's approaching 50, older people, you know, can still be, you know, funky and have, you know, active lives in all ways, and that obviously is a good thing. The problem is that I don't believe in any of these people or their lives whatsoever. So the Muriel Strepsil character, she works, apparently. And we know that she works because every now and then she is seen doing a little bit of cooking. And at one point she's seen doing some gardening, although it looks like she spent 4 hours in the makeup tent before going out to the garden. And in fact, they all look unfeasibly glamorous, even in the moments when they're doing the thing stuff about, oh, look how bad I look, because the gag is, you know, we're all past our prime, everything's sagged, but you know what, still, you know, we can all be sort of, you know, sexy and exciting, can't we? Alec Baldwin does a lot of stuff about the fact that he's fat. He walks around in his boxers shorts, and he's got, you know, quite impressive gut, although frankly I can't talk, but they still look essentially like movie stars, and they appear to be living movie star lives, and they have long lunches together in very expensive hotels, and they, you know, they book into restaurants willy-nilly, and they have the most annoying grown-up children you have ever come across in your life. So there is
why
this...
are they annoying? I can't believe grown-up children could possibly be annoying, but
why is that?
I just can't imagine that.
Well, because they're just incredibly grating and irritating and exist only in the kind of movies that are made in which everybody has, you know, always got a, you know, perfect hairdo and oh, it's really, you know, it's difficult, I'm late for lunch, that sort of thing. And the biggest problem for me about the movie, however, except, you know, all those other things that are wrong with it, is it's the Meryl Streep performance that is Meryl Streep doing comedy. Now, I like Meryl Streep enough. You know, I think Meryl Streep has done some fine stuff in her time, and she's in Mamma Mia, which, as we all know, is a complete car crash of a film, but is, you know, is kind of entertaining. But she's developed this thing. You know, when Meryl Streep started out, and it was Deer Hunter, and it was Sophie's Choice, and I mean, there was a story that was told about her by Hector Babenko, who said that when she was in Ironweed, she method acted being dead. Because there was a point in the film in which she had to be dead, right? So what she did was she came in to the room hours before anybody else, and she lay down on the floor and methoded herself into death. And then everyone came and set the lights up around her, and then they did the scene around her, and then everyone went away, and then she came out of the thing. And Hector Babenko said, "Now that's what I call acting." You know, she was the Robert De Niro of her gender in terms of, and yet, as has he done, she's moved in later life into comedy performances. But Meryl Streep's comedy performances are an odd thing. And in this movie, she does the default Meryl Streep comedy, which is, what's funny is, my face, well, not my face, being Meryl's face, will do every emotion in about 3 or 4 seconds, as if I'm on a permanent, I can't quite decide whether I'm happy or sad. Because what she's trying to show you is that she's conflicted. So it means, ha ha ha. So every line goes, and then goes another, and then goes up like that. And, goes, how are you? And so somebody says, for example, how are you doing? And the answer to the question, how are you doing? How am I doing? How am I? Well, I asked you, the way I'm doing is, and then we're, and it's really odd. It's like watching somebody being controlled by a kid with a remote control going, happy, sad, happy, sad. Remember that thing that kids used to do on a video cam, you know, happy, sad, but it's like that, but without the hands. And after a while, it becomes quite tiring. She'd be lying in bed with Alec Baldwin, and Alec Baldwin will be doing the Alec Baldwin performance, which is, you know, I'm corpulent, but I'm still Alec Baldwin. And Meryl Streep will be going, oh, it's really good. It's really quite off-putting. And after a while, it started to grate, and I got fed up.
Could it possibly be as grating as that way you acted it out yourself, with a big fat kind of almost semi-pornographic Alec Baldwin lying out?
Well,
Meryl's
response to that question would be, well, I'm going, I think, no, I go, and like that. It's really
odd. It's like
odd.
A Punch and Judy character.
I know, that's what it's like. It's like going for, in one sentence, it's
that's
like going,
the way to do it.
You know, oh, yes, he's great. And in here, this is, it's like her face is experimenting with emotions.